A great way to improve a web map is to simplify its pop-ups. Hi, I'm Heather and I'm a cartographer. In this video, I'll share a few tips for improving pop-ups in ArcGIS Online. Just because you don't have time to make fancy pop-ups doesn't mean you can't improve them. First, not every layer in your map needs to have a pop-up. It's frustrating to click a feature only to get a pop-up for a different feature that you don't care about. You can click these arrows to see more pop-ups, but are you confident that your audience will do that? Take a look at your layers and decide which ones really need pop-ups and which ones don't. For those that don't, open the pop-ups pane and disable them. So that's level one of pop-up improvements. Turn off pop-ups for layers that don't need them. If that's all you do, you have improved your map. Level two is to turn off fields that aren't needed. Most of the time, most of the fields can be removed. When you're choosing which fields to keep, ask yourself some questions. Do all of the features have the same value? Every single one of these features has the same feature type, so I should be communicating that information in the layer name and in the symbol rather than in an extra line taking up space in the pop-up. Is it redundant with the pop-up's title or with other fields? This facility name field is already used in the title, so I can get rid of it. Is it information that your audience cares about? To answer this question, you need to know who your audience is. This map is intended for people who want to enjoy parks and trails in the city, and I don't think they care about any of these ID fields. Is it important to the story you're trying to tell with this map? To answer this question, you need to know the purpose of your map. If the purpose of this map had to do with planning or maintenance, the district number might be relevant. But the purpose of this map is actually to encourage more public use of these facilities, so I don't need this field. Is it personal identification information that is better not shared? This field lists the last person to update the data, and the public doesn't need to know their name. Will your audience understand what the field represents? I don't know what Source Accuracy Interactive means, which is a good sign that probably my audience doesn't know either. If it's something they need to know, you should add extra information to explain it. Otherwise, though, remove the field. Looking at the remaining fields in this pop-up, I think I can also remove the date fields and the data source. All of the other ones look like they would be genuinely useful for someone planning an outing. And because the pop-up is no longer cluttered with a lot of other fields, it's a lot easier for someone to quickly get the information they need. You've now passed level two of pop-up improvements. Remove fields that aren't needed. Let's move to level three, configuring the fields. That happens in the fields pane. You'll often have fields with cryptic names. I know that WW is shorthand for width, but my audience does not. If there's any chance of misunderstanding, it's worth opening the fields pane and editing the field's display name. I'll make sure to use capital W so it matches the formatting of my other fields. And this is a numeric field, so maybe I need to specify the unit. The unit is meters, it says so in the field below, but it would be a lot easier to understand if it just said so here. Finally, I don't need to show decimal places. That level of detail isn't necessary for my target audience, and a rounded number is faster to read and simpler to understand. I'll make the same changes to the length field. This time, I'll also turn on the thousands separator, since I have at least one trail that is longer than 1,000 meters. Back in the pop-ups pane, I can remove the unit of measure fields. They're redundant now because I added that little M. My pop-ups are now simple and clear. There's a lot more you can do with pop-ups, especially if you use Arcade. You absolutely do not need to include a table of fields. You can express that information in texts or in charts instead. You can add links and pictures. But my point is that even if you don't have time to do all those fancy things, you can still remove pop-ups that aren't needed, remove fields that aren't needed, and configure fields. These small changes to your pop-ups can make a big improvement to your map.